So, 62-year-old man with 38-pack-year smoking habit presents with a productive cough of yellow sputum. No fever, chills. Similar events over the last few years. Temps 984, pulse 78, respirations 18, blood pressure 136 over 78, and an SO2 of 96%. Lungs have scattered crackles and faint wheezes that resolve when the patient coughs. What's the most likely diagnosis? All right, looking at these, let's just walk through them, ladies and gentlemen. First and foremost, what's everything we know about alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency? Well, it's someone that's going to get really, really bad emphysema. If they don't smoke, they'll get it, or if they smoke, they get it at a really young age. If they say someone smokes 5-pack years and next thing you know, they have emphysema, that'd be pretty quick. Maybe it's an alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency, and they were going to get it no matter what. Listen to me. What is the difference between emphysema and chronic bronchitis? What's the difference between the two? Remember, emphysema is holes in the lungs. It's holes. How do they typically present? Basically, they have shortness of breath and they get right heart failure. And remember, right heart failure is, what are the two major roads that lead to the heart? It's JVD, hepatojugular reflex, ascites, and edema. So that's emphysema. Emphysema normally has dry lungs. They're not coughing up a lot of mucus, as opposed to chronic bronchitis. So if I said to you, how do we diagnose chronic bronchitis? Well, remember, ladies and gentlemen, that's based on history. That's based on history. Over the last 2 years, have you coughed up gook 25% of the time? Or 3 months per year for the last 2 years. So that's just a fancy way of saying over the last 2 years, if you coughed up crap about 25% of the time. So this is someone who'd have repeated episodes of this frequently, and they're coughing up crap all the time. I keep saying crack. Atypical pneumonia. Well, wait a second. If they said atypical pneumonia, I mean, that means atypical germ. So that's MCL, Mycoplasma, Chlamydia, and Legionella. And we know that we treat atypicals with macrolides. So that's the MCL. And ladies and gentlemen, just allergic asthma, I think, is a really, really silly thing to even suggest. Asthma, by definition, is kind of allergic in nature. It's allergic, but that's not a real medical disease. We don't call it allergic asthma. That's not right. So anytime you see an answer and you go, what? It's not right. Okay, so this is a classic chronic bronchitis versus emphysema question, because remember, whenever you have two things that are similar, you have to know how to compare and contrast them. And if I look in the base question, ladies and gentlemen, he's had similar events over the last few years. So that suggests, remember, chronic bronchitis is someone who always is coughing up crap, but it seems crack, seem crack, but it wants to get infected. So 62-year-old with a 38-pack-year habit with a productive cough of yellow sputum. Okay, so that is more suggestive of chronic bronchitis than emphysema. No fever, chills, atypical pneumonias, they can be with or without fever, but oftentimes it's indiscriminate whether you can describe a patient's germ by their presentation. So we used to think atypical pneumonias had a certain presentation and that typical pneumonias had a certain presentation, but that's kind of fallen out of favor. So one of the things that confuses me a little about this question is lungs have scattered crackles and faint wheezing. Now, crackles typically represents fluid at the alveolar level, where normally chronic bronchitis has bronchi. Not a big deal. That resolves when the patient coughs. Okay, well, when something resolves when the patient coughs, that is more bronchitis. Remember, you do that and your pulmonary status cleans up. That's more suggestive of bronchi. So when I look at this question, this points a whole lot more towards chronic bronchitis than than emphysema. Remember, there's three things in the bucket of COPD: emphysema, chronic bronchitis, and reactive disease.